good evening. I want to share with you tonight a collaboration that will enable people to change the world in a profoundly positive way. This is a TED success story in the making. It's the evolution of an idea worth spreading. A couple months ago, I returned home to Earth after 5.5 months of... I guess that is funny. After 5.5 months living and working on board the International Space Station, one of the greatest collaborative achievements in human history, this enormous orbiting complex was built in space by 15 nations, all working together to advance shared human knowledge for the benefit of all. Proof that nothing is impossible. I was born at the height of the Cold War, in the very year that Yuri Gagarin became the first human to orbit the Earth. 50 years later, almost to the day, from that very same launch pad, during the 50th anniversary celebrations, I launched into space with a couple of Russian guys on a spacecraft called Gagarin. Proof again that nothing is impossible. While I was in space, I took this picture of the UK on the eve of the royal wedding. A few weeks later, I gave a TED talk from space to TED Global. And in that talk, I discussed the concept of the orbital perspective, that perspective that gives us a real sense, a tactile understanding, if you will, that we're all interconnected and we are all in this together. I also discussed an initiative called Fragile Oasis, which uses that orbital perspective to inspire people to go out and make a difference and to affect real positive change. It's basically a collaboration project. It is clear that there is a number of organizations around the world that are trying to build collaborative platforms, tried to build tools that organizations can use to work together towards their common goal. So at TEDx Vienna last November, we offered an invitation to organizations around the world to come together and work on a collaboration project. Since then, this initiative continues to gain more and more momentum. The team gets bigger and bigger, and we are learning more and more. And tonight, I want to announce the launch of the Unity Node project. And this is the TED success story in the making and the direct result of an idea worth spreading. But before I get into the specifics of the Unity Node project, I wanted to just take a couple minutes and to a little more deeply explain to you what I mean by the orbital perspective. About a month before I returned to Earth, I flew to the windowed observatory called the Cupola on the International Space Station. And this is a picture of me in that facility. I wanted to take some pictures for a time-lapse photography project for Fragile Oasis that I'll show you a little bit of later in the presentation. But as I was taking practice shots, I saw this strange sight. An illuminated line was stretching and snaking for hundreds of miles across a landmass. Initially, I wrote this off as a strange reflection of moonlight on a river. I was very intrigued. It turns out that this was not a natural reflection at all. I've always said that you can't see any borders from space. Apparently, I was wrong, because what this actually is the man-made illuminated border between India and Pakistan to control passage between those two countries. And realizing this had a really big impact on me. The Earth, when viewed from space, almost always looks beautiful and peaceful, but this was an example of man-made changes to the landscape that was clearly visible from space. Throughout the history of human spaceflight for the last 50 years, astronauts and cosmonauts have commented on how beautiful, how fragile, how peaceful the Earth looks from space. And these are not cliches that astronauts say because it feels good. It truly is moving to look at the Earth from space. The point is not that we could look down and see a border, a man-made border between India and Pakistan. The point is we could look down at that same area and feel empathy for the struggles that all people face. We could look down and from our orbital perspective and realize that each and every one of us is riding through the universe on this spaceship that we call Earth, that we're all in this together, we're all interconnected, that we're all family. And that's what we call the orbital perspective. These man-made changes to the environment are all the more striking because of the beauty of our planet. And when we look at our planet, we're faced with an undeniable, sobering contradiction. On the one hand, we can clearly see the beauty of the planet that we've been given. On the other hand, is the unfortunate reality of life on our planet for a significant portion of its inhabitants. We have the resources, we have the technology to solve many, if not all, of the problems facing our planet, yet nearly a billion people don't have access to clean water, countless go to bed every night hungry, and many die from completely curable and preventable diseases. We live in a world where the possibilities are only limited by our imagination and our will to act. It is within our power to reduce or eliminate the suffering and the poverty that exists on our planet. The answer is quite simple. Just do something. The problems that face our planet are really, they really come down to how each of us, on an individual, person-to-person basis, commits to make a positive change, no matter how small or how big. The good news is that people are doing things, and there's about 20 million organizations around the world that are trying to improve life on Earth where people can lend a hand. The bad news is, for the most part, these organizations are not engaged in a unified, coordinated effort. There's a lot of duplication of effort, and there is a lot of loss of efficiency. There has to be, well, just to illustrate the point, let's say there's somebody who wants to help provide clean water, or maybe they want to donate some money to one of the many organizations that do that. They are faced with a confusing myriad of organizations, of technologies, of approaches. Another person may be the leader of a humanitarian organization that faces a critical problem, not knowing that another organization has already solved that problem, and the path that her organization is going down is going to lead to a dead end. Another person lives in a village where the village faces life-threatening problems, while a humanitarian organization is planning projects in that area, but it doesn't know the situation in the village. There has to be a way for us all to work together towards our common goals. Excuse me. It is clear that there is a number of organizations around the world that are working to provide that collaborative platform. It is critical to unify those efforts. We are calling the mechanism that we will build to do just that, Unity Node. The first node of the International Space Station was launched to be a central connector of all the other modules on the space station. The name signifies and demonstrates the inspiration that we have for this vision of collaboration. Just as the Unity Node on the International Space Station connects the different modules, so too will this Unity Node connect the different organizations around the world and help them to provide an easier way for them to collaborate. Unity Node will be a connector. It will connect humanity's changemakers to the problems facing the planet and to each other through a unified, open source method of collaboration. There are two pieces of Unity Node. The first is the central data tool. And connected to the central data tool are outward-facing apps that make data usable and accessible. The data tool is the heart of the system. The data tool I'm calling it a data tool because it's much more than a database. Our goal is to create a mechanism where databases can talk to each other and organizations can share that information that they feel comfortable sharing. The goal is to provide a way, ideally this would be transparent, for organizations, when feasible, to share and tie their databases, their social networks, their data visualizations to the wider global community, thereby making them much more efficient and much more effective. Connected to this central data tool will be the outward-facing apps. They would be designed by individual users to meet the needs of their individual organizations. They could contain databases of needs and different projects that would connect to the overall global database. You could have an interactive project map to enable local connections. A social media tool will open up conversations where people are. One of my favorite apps, if you will, is a dashboard of Earth, which would show progress toward certain development goals like the provision of clean water, food, education, et cetera. One of the key challenges is to demonstrate just how critically important and valuable collaboration truly is. Collaborative solutions are better because people can pool resources, they can pool information, it multiplies cost effectiveness while reducing duplication of effort. It's really the only way to enable economies and solutions of scale, and probably most importantly, it encourages greater accountability and fosters trust. So you probably heard me say the word we throughout this presentation, and we is the story here. The we that I'm referring to here is the individuals and the organizations that are coming together to build Unity Node. The Unity Node story is the collaboration itself. It's not the technology, it's not the tool, it's the people who affect real change. I just want to close with a video that shows my return to Earth, and I took my return to Earth as a call to action.
After 5.5 months in space, it was time to say goodbye to our friends and to our home on the International Space Station. We were very eager to return to Earth, but we wanted to savor our last moments in space as we did a couple of laps around our beautiful planet. As we boarded our capsule to come home, I left space with a call to action to spread the orbital perspective and a commitment not to accept the status quo on our planet. Realize that for thousands of years of human history, the vast majority of the people in the world believed that it was impossible to fly to the moon, simply because it had never been done before. Human ingenuity and the determination of the human spirit proved that it was possible. Today, many people believe that it's impossible to solve the problems of the world or change the poverty that so many face. They believe that humans are not capable to come together, putting aside their differences, to address and solve the problems that face us. If we can land on the moon and return to Earth safely, if nations can join together and build an enormous research facility in orbit, we can work together to solve many of the challenges facing our planet, including the alleviation of poverty. Nothing is impossible.
Then we got up on two legs, but we wanted to fly. And when we messed up our homeland,
You don't have to be in orbit to have the orbital perspective, and you don't have to accept things the way they are. The Unity node is invested in changing that sobering contradiction by making and helping to make the world not only visibly beautiful, but one where life is beautiful for all. So we'll just end this with asking you, what kind of world do you want? And this is us at the launch facility in Kazakhstan. Thank you.